Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to explore more on the Lambda and API gateway. We will create these APIs, box get, box post and HTTP put. So we are covering get, put, post. So you will have more understanding on HTTP methods, resources and all different things from the API gateway. And obviously the request response lifecycle, which we have here. So we can just delete this resource. Okay, now we have everything empty. Now if we just go to the API gateway, this is our API gateway. And I mean, whenever you are creating a new API, there are all different options you have. You can actually choose a Swagger YML also. So that is the beauty of API gateway. If you have a Swagger YML, then obviously you can just create it from there, clone from the existing API. You can select the existing API we already have and create a new API for this. Or you can also set up example API. It already has the Swagger YML. So whenever you create it, it will expose all those endpoints. Like it's a pet store. So it has some HTTP get, put, post methods. We already have our API. So we will start with there. Test gateway. And in the last video, we already have looked into the request response lifecycle. So here we will create a resource. Okay. Resources like books. You should always keep this same. I mean, you can change it, but keeping the same would be good, like the resource name and the endpoint. And here you will see the enable API gateway calls, right? So whenever you hit any request from the front end, you might have seen the cross origin resource sharing error, right, on your browser console. So what is that? Because from your browser, you are making requests from A domain to B domain, and the domain can be differ either from the protocol, from the domain name, like you are making a request from one domain to another subdomain, or your protocols are different, port are different. Then browser will block all those kind of requests. So if I enable this, then it will create the option request for me with this resource books. So it's creating, and you can see the option request. And what extra it is adding? Whenever you need to handle these cross-origin resource sharing errors, what you need to do in the response headers, you just need to send these headers, okay? Allow cross-origin, I mean all origins from wherever you are making a request, all are allowed for all these HTTP methods, and it is just adding these set of headers, right? So this resource will never get cross-origin resource sharing error from the browser console because you have added you have enabled it, okay? Now I can just create a method. So we have this create method, and I can just do get books get. Okay, similarly we can add another method on the books resource, create method, and it can be post. Let's first talk about get. Okay, we just need to create a lambdas for it. So what I will do is I will delete this lambda. It just test lambda we have created. So here I will create a function bookstore fetch. Okay, and execution role, we are going to access DynamoDB later, but here we are just creating a simple lambda. So I will just assign this lambda role because we have to assign some role, otherwise it will create another role for it. Okay, bookstore fetch I have assigned. I can just save it and we'll deploy it. So now API gateway, I can just add an integration to this. We have created a lambda, so I need to reload it. Okay, not showing that lambda. I need to just check the region, it's US East 1. Yes, bookstore fetch. It's just a refresh issue that you have to refresh your browser to see the latest lambda you have created. Okay, now we will again get into this method request, which is a gatekeeper method response. You wanted to transform a response, like adding some particular header and all these things you can do here. So it's like a method request is a gatekeeper, which is validating your request body, request parameter, integration request is handling the integration of your API endpoint with Lambda, HTTP endpoint or mock. And here you can also add a mapping template. Like you have to create a new template, like add mapping template. So here, if I just click on to this, it is strange. Okay, I'm in the integration request. So here integration response, if you want to add some header mappings and all, then you can do here. And you can also add a custom templates for the response if you want to just set a particular format of the response. So this is a response transformer and it is a method response. It will never block any request. It is just sending the response back. If you want to add a particular headers, all those things can go here. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is option request, we are fine. And we have HTTP GET. So we have integration with simple Lambda. We can just test it. Unsupported media type. Let's see this. So we haven't deployed this. Did I change anything in the method request mapping template? No. So here we are testing HTTP GET. Yes, it is coming now. So this is HTTP GET. Similarly, we can create another Lambda bookstore create. Okay. Another use an existing rule. And here we have created this function. Similarly, let's create another resource on top of this, which is okay. We need to have ID. So this is, you can add a path parameter using brackets, for example, something like this. So resource name, if I put ID, will it work? Enable cross origin resource sharing on this. Okay, create resource. And here we are in the books, we will have the ID endpoint. Okay, and for this also, we can create a Lambda. It can be simple bookstore get. Use an existing role. And we do have Lambda. So now we just deploy these simple Lambdas. So this is option request. We will create a method in on top of this, which is create method HTTP get. And we will associate this to the Lambda. Okay, why it is showing the old one? Let me just refresh it. Bookstore. Okay, I need to type something. Bookstore get. So we have created this endpoint. Now the only tricky thing is how we can get this ID parameter, because it's a request parameter, right? And before returning the response for a particular book, we have to get this ID. These are the books, get and post. That means you return all the books from database or just mock response. You create something here, you have to return a particular book. So we have to read this ID request parameter here. Like if I just try to test it, then it is asking ID, right? So if you do the test, right now we are not doing anything with the ID. We are just sending the response back. But in the real scenarios, you will be extracting this ID from the request parameter, which is like query string. Okay, and then you will be processing your request and sending the response. Okay, that we will see in the next video with understanding more about this method request and understanding this request body template. Okay, request body, model templates, request validation, which this method request gatekeeper is doing. Then we have to understand about integration response if you want to send a response back in a particular format. These are the only important request response lifecycle, because people get confused. First of all, what is this option request? Most of the people will encounter this, that they are not able to make a call to the API gateway endpoint after deploying it. right? Because you haven't enabled the option request with the cross enable, right? Cross origin resource sharing policy, it violates it and you will get a console error. So you have to enable, you have to add option request for your resource. Like ID resource I have added, for the books resource I have added. Okay, that's it. Thanks everyone.